I'm asked every day about the addictive nature of sugar. So let me give you a little background. Number one, human beings do eat sugar, have eaten sugar for millennia. However, anything over one teaspoon is poison. And that's why insulin is elevated, because without insulin, the sugar would go out of control and you would die. But on the other hand, you do need glucose. So this is a paradox. And I call this the dose is the poison. So yes, you need just a tiny little bit of glucose in the form of carbohydrates, but your main diet should be meat. Now that's where we get into the debate of the carnivore diet. But living in an urban society, it's not easy to live like Lucy, our ancestor. So that's why I've developed this concept of the urban carnivore. What and where can we get our food? How much of this carbohydrate should we eat? And should that be devoid of chemicals such as glyphosate? Absolutely. But everything in the grocery store is laced with high fructose corn syrup. Why? Because it tastes great. And it is addicting. And it starts in childhood. What do? Not breast milk. We give them formula, which is sugar. Kids love sugar, and that's how we addict them. So that starts with the hypothesis that fat was bad, Ansel Keys back in the 60s, and teaching the American public and the entire Western world that fat was bad, and by default, sugar is good. That was a misnomer, shall we use that word, in the 60s? Deception in the 70s, outright fraud today. If you don't know that sugar is bad and fat is good, then you have been deceived, or you're being enriched by telling that false narrative. And that's what's happening. America's sick, America is fat, and they're addicted. So how do we get off of this? First of all, we have to realize we have been deceived. Number two, we need a pathway to get off of sugar. And in my opinion, that is to understand the benefits of fat, good fat, natural fats, fat from animal products. Now, I know there's a debate between the herbivores, vegetarians, and the carnivores. I get that. We are omnivores, meaning we can eat both sides of that equation. But if you want to be healthy, you need to lean to the carnivore. Now, the pushback I get from the vegetarians is, I think, more of a ethical type of discussion, animal lovers, and they don't want to eat animal products. I get that. But if you're eating a vegetarian diet, you're most likely to have lots and lots of inflammatory diseases, from irritable bowel to MS, etc., etc., etc. You have to add the B vitamins back into your diet. You have to add fats back into your diet. And plant fats are not exactly the same as animal fats. You need DHEA and you need EPA. So these are fats that are essential to the diet. And you need B12. If you're on a strictly vegetarian diet, you're not going to get B vitamins. Why is B vitamins essential, and you only can get it from meat, is because it operates the nervous system. And if you don't have other vitamins like thiamine, you're going to get a disease. I mean, it's that simple. So if you're a vegetarian, you need to supplement. You have to. And if you're a carnivore, you're getting all those natural ingredients, including the B vitamins. Now, another subject is the fiber. I hear that all day long. You need to eat your fiber. No, you don't. All you need is eat meat. Meat is digested quickly through the alimentary canal, and it does not cause irritation of the stomach or in the intestine. Fiber does. It bulks it up. It stretches out the intestinal tract. I know it's told all day long by allopathic medicine, eat the food pyramid, which means 6 to 11 helpings on the bottom of the pyramid and the oils and fats at the top. Eat your fruits and vegetables. If you do that, you will be fat, no question about it, and you will be on 20 drugs. You need to do exact opposite. It's not my opinion. It's the opinion, as I like to say, of mirrors. Look in the mirror. If you like what you see, keep doing it. If you don't, don't.